Well, first of all, thank you so much for the amazing response that I got from you guys last week to the question that we were talking about, which was, if you could know the truth about anything, what would it be and why? And I got loads of stuff back from you, and the things you wanted to know more than anything else were these two. Number one, is there really a God? And number two was, how was the universe created, or how was the universe made? Those were the two things that you really wanted to know. Is there really a God, and how was the universe made? And I found it really interesting, actually, that you asked, how was the universe made or created, using those words, because that kind of implies that there's a maker or a creator. And yet at the same time, you're not really sure whether there really is a God, and there's some uncertainty about whether he's really there, which is quite understandable. And I think that's very, very common for people to not be sure whether God is really there. But I wonder if we can be sure whether God is there or not. Let's see what we can find out this term by asking some really good questions and carrying on the debate back and forth. Let's see what information we can find out so that we can be sure one way or the other if God is really there. So this week, I just want to read to you a little bit of a letter from a friend of mine who doesn't believe in God, and he's explaining why he doesn't believe in God. I'm going to read you a little bit of that, and then I'm going to give you another question to think about and chat about this week, and get back to me about it as well. After high school, I joined the army, and in 1998, I was deployed to Bosnia. There, I saw enormous cemeteries, too many to count, and in some cases, too large to stand and view their borders, filled with the victims of the war. I saw old grey women in the streets, forced to beg for money because they lost their legs to landmines hastily left in their backyards during the war. I saw other women standing in the marketplaces, holding up pictures of their sons or husbands, men who died in the war, asking us soldiers if we knew where they could go for financial aid. On multiple occasions, my team and I were approached by Muslim extremists, people who yelled at and spat in our faces and wished for our deaths, none deterred by the loaded M16 rifles on our shoulders. It was in Bosnia that I asked myself if I was absolutely sure I believed in God. So you've heard a few words from a really genuine and decent guy who just can't bring himself to believe in God for one reason or another. And here we are with loads of us wanting to know whether God is really there or not. And I think that this term, we can start finding out for sure one way or the other whether he's really there. So here is this week's question that I'd like you to give some serious thought to and talk about it today and get back to me. What kind of things could we discover that might convince us God is real?
Will it blend? That is the question. I love my new iPhone. It does everything. But will it blend? That is the question. Let's find out. I think I'm going to push the smoothie button. I smoke. Don't breathe this. Now, you fans on YouTube have asked me to blend an iPhone. So I did it. But I have another. I'm going to put this on eBay.